would you recommend then that people spend time and energy on providing services to the field? I know that in my time, my senior colleagues told me that I shouldn't even bother writing, for example, books or book chapters because they don't count. So I should focus only on the journals that are on the list of the department, because everything else is basically a waste of time if you want to get promoted. Now, you started compiling these services pretty early on in your career. Mm-hmm. And so my students are looking at you and saying, well, maybe I should do something like that. But then it will take so much time. So is it worth it? Or should I wait until I get, you know, promoted and get tenure, and maybe then I will spend time on this? What's your philosophy on helping the field and using your own time and resources to provide a service to the field?
Yeah, very, very good question again. And I think very useful for the audience as well. I would say I would make a slight distinction between the US and other countries that have a formal tenure system, where you have a tenure track position and you have 5 or 6 years to get the number of publications at the right level, and countries that provide academics even at a junior level with permanent appointments. If you are in a tenure track, then I would say the advice of focusing on your publications is probably a sensible one. Because it's a very short period and requirements at most universities are pretty high. Yeah. So, but that's the first 5 or 6 years of your career.
Yeah.
For many of us, an academic career is at least 40 years. It might be 50 years. It might even be longer. So that leaves you with a lot of time. And you don't all have to do this kind of service at the same level. I know of us, you've been doing things and you're probably still doing things in terms of measurement of culture.
You prompted me actually. I had that question. So those who don't know, I compile a catalog of instruments for measuring culture and then a catalog of instruments for measuring acculturation. And when I started doing that again, it was a byproduct of my own research. Several colleagues told me, don't spend time on this. Mm-hmm. And Will, we talked about that, I think it was in Honolulu, must have been at a conference. And she said, no, spend time, you'll get something back. And you were right. So not only did I get a lot of, literally over the years, hundreds if not thousands of thank you notes, but I have actually a few papers out of that. People came to me and said, I read your catalog, I'm working on a paper, would you like to be my co-author? I still had to put in time, but I did get some relationships from that effort that I would have not gotten otherwise. So.
Exactly. But the thing is, Vas, you probably wouldn't have got that if your only aim had been to gain something from it.
Right. Yeah, of course not. Yes.
So we offer these services because they help ourselves. And oftentimes these things are a byproduct of your PhD or a research project you're doing. And then you make them available to the rest of the world, without expectation of getting anything in return. But it often turns into kind of a manifesto of, this is what I'm interested in. So it draws people to you if they're also interested in this particular area. And it might lead you to other research projects and collaborations. And in my case, certainly Publisher Paris, less so the Journal Quality List, but also a little bit in terms of the Journal Quality List. Publisher Paris has led to a whole new area of research for me because I've done quite a lot of work on the measurements of research and research evaluation, and we'll talk about that a bit more. But I would never have done that if I didn't have Publisher Paris, because I use Publisher Paris to do the research as well. I collected the data with Publisher Paris. I ended up publishing about 15 articles in the field of cytometrics. And some of them are actually among my most highly cited work.
In fact, I'm looking at the citations here as we speak. So your most cited work is Publisher Paris.
Then
the third most cited with the cool lucky citation count as of today, 777. That's a publication, Google Scholar, as a new source for citation analysis. So it's a paper on Publisher Paris.
Yeah.
So I guess there is something coming out of it.
Yeah. So yes, it might benefit your own career in the end. But if you, and that's the thing, if you only do things because you think they will benefit you, then you will find they won't. It's often the unintended consequences, exactly. The serendipity of it.